Myself, S.P.Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Wolchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss the principles of the building planning. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to impart the knowledge and apply the principles of planning and design of the residential buildings. There are different types of the planning, as we have the administrative planning, the environment planning, etc. So we will be discussing about the building planning. A planning of the building is nothing but the grouping and the arrangement of the components of all the units of a building in a systematic manner, in according to their functional requirement, to make the best use of the space available, and also it should form a homogeneous unit. In general, the planning of the building depends on the first we have the functional object and the requirement. Second is the component parts, size and the interrelationship. Third, we have the topography and shape of the plot. Fourth is the climatic conditions. Fifth is the locations and the neighborhood. The planning of the building will be depending on these all points. In general, functional object means for what purpose the building has to be constructed. That will be the main object, and as per that we have to take the requirements of the building and the component parts, that means the door, windows, where it should be placed. Overall, we have to take the sizes of that, and even the door should be placed in front of the window. In that way we have to do the planning and topography. The plot over there, it should have a strong foundation. The strata should be in such a way that it should support the foundation work. And shape of the plot, it should be mostly rectangular in shape so that the placing of all the rooms can be done easily. And the climatic conditions. Climatic conditions in general includes the nature gifts like the air and the light. Even the locations and the neighborhood. The building should be located in such an area that the town, it should consist of around 10,000 population, and in that you can have even the subcontinents in that, as per the one of the town, it may be divided into subdivisions, as a single town will be consisting of 2,000 to 5,000 per population, which will be easily accommodated in one of the primary school, which is in short a demand of a primary school. So in that way, that should be also a factor which should be considered in planning of the building. And the neighborhood should be such that we should have a healthy environment, and even the living conditions over there can be easily improved due to that climatic conditions. And neighbors which we are staying nearby should be approximately equal to our status, so that we can easily have a communication between us, and which may not affect any of the neighborhood. Principles of planning includes the 11th planning. Overall, the size, it includes the town, which is divided into the subcontinents or the sectors. Around 10,000 population can easily accommodate in that, which may be further subdivided into subcontinents, around 2,000 to 5,000, so that it will be a demand of one primary school. So that, and the boundaries in that, the plot should be located such that it consists of the main roads from all the four sides. Protective strips in general, it should be provided to protect the traffic. So next we have the layout of the buildings. Encourage the neighborhood planning. Family houses. Different houses such as the double family houses and the single family houses, cottage, plots, etc., which will be the layout of the buildings. The shopping centers should also be provided in the nearby area. Aspect includes the placement of the different rooms of a house in consideration with the activities which can be done in different hours or in the day. The room which receives the light and the air in particular direction is said to have the aspect of that direction. In general, here we can see one of the example as table which is done. Here you can see the bedroom, that is the aspect. It gets the light and the air from the west direction, northwest and the southwest. So the influencing factor will be to influence the plentiful of breeze in summer. This is during the summer. So here you can see even the kitchen, it is placed in the east and the northeast direction, so that throughout the whole day it keeps cool, so that here you can see the influencing factor is to receive the morning sun. This is germicidal. It purifies the air. It should be well illuminated and cool in the afternoon. So for that purpose, the kitchen is placed in the east and the northeast direction, so that the aspect will be east direction. Next we have the dining room. Here you can see the aspect of the dining room is south, southeast and southwest. Proximity of the kitchen. It should be cool. That means the kitchen food materials are kept in the dining. So it should be cool. The drawing room. The aspect of the drawing room is south, southeast and southwest. So adequate natural lighting during the winter, and it obviate the sun during the summer. This is the purpose of the placing the drawing room in the south and the southeast direction. So the reading room, it has the aspect of north and the northwest direction. The light from the north been different evenly distributes and remains cool. And the storeroom should be placed in the north or the northwest, northeast direction. That means it will be dark and even cool it will be throughout the day. So in general, the aspect means the room which receives the light from light and the air in particular direction. That means it has the aspect of that direction. Is the prospect. Prospect is the impression that a house is likely to make on the person who looks it from outside. So this is exactly the one which is related to aspect. That means they both play the similar role, which will be the placement of the doors, relatives and the windows. So it refers to a view, a scene of the outside of a building from the windows and the doors in the external wall. So this is the bedroom. In the cold region, it gets the sunshine early in the morning. So the bedroom in the west or the southwest direction, that means it has the aspect of that direction. So the living room, the opening in the north, northeast makes northeast makes the living room more comfortable throughout the day. The living room facing the south receives the maximum sunlight during the day. This is the example of the tropical country. Here you can see that the balcony should be either towards the east or the west. The balcony or the veranda should be preferred on the west side to keep the adjoining room cool. The windows on the east or the west side and the south side should be provided with the weather shade to cut off the sun rays. For the residential building planning, privacy is also an important consideration. For more privacy, center door should be avoided, so that we can it can be achieved by proper positioning of the doors and the windows, and while grouping of the units, positioning. In short, we have to see the positioning of the doors and the windows, where exactly they have to be placed to avoid the privacy. So proper grouping of the room has is an important factor which includes in the privacy. Also plant, we can even plant the trees around the compound walls to avoid the sound privacy. The grouping refers to be easy communication and utility of the various rooms. The kitchen and the dining room should be close to each other. The bedroom connected to the bath and less exposed to the drawing room. These are the factors which should be considered while grouping the units, which are nice. It is the feel of the spaciousness obtained in the room when one enters it. Rectangular room should be considered so that we feel precious, and even the light colors and also different colors on each wall depending on the light conditions, light direction, can also improve the roominess. This is achieved between 1.2 to 1.5 as we feel the preciousness of that room. Next is the flexibility. The plan of the building should be prepared by keeping in view the future requirement. The room which is planned for one function can also be used for the another function if required. These are the references which I have referred. Thank you.